What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's Dan here. I'd like to welcome you guys back to UFC. What is going on? Unique New York. I didn't do my vocal exercises because I can't say UFC 2 career female version. Damn! I'm sorry. What's going on, guys? Welcome back. We got a lot of experience points to spend, but we also have to choose our next fight. So let's go ahead and take a sneak peek. Can't remember what we did when we left off. Did I not fight Misha Tate? I'm pretty sure I did. And up next on our fighting list, we could choose, actually. We could either go with Elizabeth Phillips. She's coming in at number 10. She's an 85 overall. But you'll get 3,500 fans from that, potential fans. And that's at UFC 200. So this one's closer than this one. So honestly, in retrospect, this makes way more sense. She's a higher ranked fighter. She's better overall. But this one it's a no-brainer. It's less fights away, so there fewer years go by, that sort of a thing. And we'll make our way up to the top a lot better. So, yeah, this is definitely a no-brainer. We're going with Elizabeth Phillips, the boxer. And right now we have a stand-up boost. Striking coach was helping out with a professional boxer's training camp and picked some new things. Training your stand-up game will result in better gains. So, fantastic. That is what I want to see. Now, unfortunately, as I'm sure you guys have seen, because I reached the first bracket, it's going to be a little bit tougher. There's going to be a bit more wear on my fighter. So what we're going to do, though, is we have some money to spend. And I think I'd rather spend it on moves. Maybe my submission moves, make them a little bit better. I think that's important. You know, like the guillotine. I use the guillotine quite often. So I think I might want to, you know, maybe... Maybe do level 4 for the guillotine. That's some serious damage right there. I haven't used a triangle that much, but the rear naked choke I've used quite often, so I'm going to go ahead and upgrade that, I think. Maybe to a level 4. What else? Rear naked choke, back mounted flat. Wow, that I have not been in that situation yet. That's awesome, though. That was quite the reversal. The Americana crucifix. Never had a chance to do that one yet, but we do have it. Armbar full mount. I think I'd like to have my armbar. I only have a couple, though. Now I only have 400, so I could... I think, you know what I'm going to do now is upgrade another takedown. The side control, the big Bertha. The double leg guard. Let's go with the single leg hat. I think it drops it into single. This is my normal one. So I'm going to go ahead and upgrade that to a level 2. Because I use that the most often. Not intentionally necessarily, but you know what I mean. All right, perfect. So we got those upgraded. Now we're going to be utilizing the training camp to our advantage. Now what I'm going to need to do is I think I'm going to have to work the legs. I have a rank of a medium here. So I'm going to have to change it though because my stamina is currently sitting. Aw, damn it. Shouldn't have stayed up all night playing that UFC game because now you'll miss the training session. Damn it. Well, suck my nuts and polish my ass. That's just shitty. Damn. All right, that's okay. My power didn't go up as high as I wanted. I can get this back, but you know what? I only have one more camp. That's the thing. So I suppose I could do this. No, but... Oh. See, I don't need the stamina boost. I need something else. I'm going to have to do clinch training, which is okay. I'm actually okay with that. Maybe go with the hard rank. Yeah. Get that boosted. Let's see what the takedown defense... I got the hard rank with that. So I could always up my takedown. You know what? I think that sounds a little more pleasant for me. So that'll bring me to a 56 leg. Oh, my takedown defense dropped. Damn! Ass! Ass! Piss coming from my ass. Oh, man. All right, so yeah, we did move up to an 84. We were an 83. And a bunch of my submissions were upgraded. So I'm going to utilize that as much as possible. Moving up the main card as well. Tate, we've taken Tate's spot on the card for being a better... Well, we did beat Tate last fight, so... Oh, I didn't even see where we were. I always forget to check. I'm in Rio, and I'm walking to the octagon. I'm in my speedo. All right, so as you can see, because of the drop, the injury, we've dropped to a 78 in the clinch. Even though we've... Oh, no, we did ground, did I? No. No, I did ground upgrade. So as soon as that injury wears off, we'll probably be a higher rank. So it dropped by... It was a large amount, which sucks, but you do what you do.
Up next, it's a women's bantamweight matchup between Razor and Elizabeth Phillips.
All right, Liz, let's get ready to rumble.
Elizabeth Phillips, very focused, well prepared, and looking for a big victory tonight.
This girl has excellent footwork. It's one of her strongest qualities. She is very difficult to hit, and she can close the distance and hit you very quickly. Very tough to train with anybody who can emulate the type of footwork that she possesses.
Elizabeth Phillips enters the octagon, set for tonight's fight.
All right, Lizzie. Ready to rock and roll, but you don't know Razor Ripley. Get away from her, you bitch! Right? What's up?
Razor, ready to go to battle and put on a show.
This girl has ridiculously impressive, lightning-fast hand speed. It is one of her best qualities and one of the most terrifying things that you could face inside the octagon. When someone is faster than you, it is such a huge advantage.
Hashtag copy that. I'm ready to rock and roll.
Ready to fight here tonight.
Razor Ripley.
In Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Our tale of the tape for this women's bantamweight fight. Razor is 22.
Look at that, rank of 8.
32.
It's my number.
Razor is 2 inches taller. She will have a 3-inch reach advantage. Once again, here's the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Brucey B, what's up, dude?
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds of the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting and out of the blue corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist on a professional record of 6 wins, 4 losses. She stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Spokane, Washington, Elizabeth Phillips! And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding professional record of 11 wins, no losses. She stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 132 pounds. Fighting out of Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, Razor!
All right, Razor. Miss Phillips.
And our referee is Eve Levine.
So I'm a higher rank than her right now. So I'm out of the red corner. It's been a while since we've been here.
3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Phillips. Black trunks for Razor. Joshi was.
Oh, I waited for that. I was pouncing.
TKO victory in her last.
Posturing up. Oh, nope.
She's a true warrior.
Oh, she got out of it. She's already on the ground.
In her division.
Going to full guard.
Nice transition to the top.
Damn, she's quick. Holy shit.
Good sweep.
Trying to sprawl.
Nice movement on the ground.
That's a risky place to be.
Bolt hooks in.
All right, I'm into full guard. Reversing. Oh, no, nope, she got out of it.
Wow, look at that.
How good is that?
Uh-oh.
Whoa.
Shot.
Oh, I got out of that, sort of.
Phillips,
Jesus, this girl's a beast.
Here's a little piece of trivia for folks who don't know. The reason why you're not allowed to do a downward elbow, 12 to 6, is because when they first brought mixed martial arts to athletic commissions, the people in the commission said, well, you can't let someone do that. I saw.
Damn, okay, that she had me there.
In reality, there's really very little difference between a downward elbow or a 45-degree elbow or what have you.
That's a huge...
Whoa, round. Jesus.
Head kick.
I got my... Come on. This girl's blocking everything. Damn.
Nice jab.
They are exchanging here, Mike.
Whoa.
Wow, what a great job mixing things up.
Big
what
nice
huge
punch.
Right hand.
Oh, God. She's...
Nice.
She got me there. Come on, I got to get out of this. Triangle choke. I didn't upgrade this.
Phillips got it back in half guard now.
Gotta get to full guard.
Full mount.
Half guarding. Get the backside.
90 seconds.
Half guard. I gotta get to full guard.
Joe, she's showcasing some great movement on the ground.
I can do rear choke.
Oh, beautiful.
Oh, she's so good at reversing. There you go. Okay, I'm in it. Oh, she got out of it. Jesus. Guillotine. I got the guillotine.
She's going after the guillotine.
She's out of it.
She got free of the choke. Half guard now.
Damn it. Holy shit. This girl does not let me.
She's back up again.
Holy crap. My heart's racing. This girl's.
Nice parry there.
Knows what she's doing.
Oh! Man, that right eye has really started to swell shut.
God, she knows what she's doing.
Phillips gets caught by the head kick. 5 minutes in the books.
Damn.
Round one complete.
I'd say she took that. She's a bit of a tough cookie, this one. I got to get back into the swing of things. Haven't played UFC for a few days.
And here's a nice shot. Lands perfectly. And here's another clean shot that lands.
Yeah. I mean, I got a few good kicks on her, though, but she had the ground control. She was just dominating on the floor.
You can really see how awesome that...
My takedowns aren't really being effective.
Second round.
Oh, she touched gloves. She was just switching sides.
Comes out swinging. That's a good kick to the body.
Oh, nice right hook, too.
Not looking so good.
There it is, swing and a miss. Joe, she's really staying busy on her feet. Good roundhouse kick to the midsection.
Oh, very nicely done.
Take a look at the numbers for Razor. Landing 44% of her kicks.
Whoa.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange.
What's going on? Nothing is working. I swear to God. Oh my gosh. I gotta back it away. That was murder. Holy shit, man. That was so weird. I was holding my right bumper. She got out of that.
Look at this. Takedown.
That saved her. Trying to guillotine. Let's see if we can guillotine.
Razor going for a submission attempt.
I upgraded my guillotine. She's switching things. It's tough to do that. Oh, my God. Trying it again. Oh.
Able to pass to half guard. She's back up.
Oh, nice.
That wasn't really a hit.
Just missed with the big left hand.
Oh, I slipped. I hate those.
Nice front kick to the body.
This damn bitch.
Hard kick. Precise straight right.
Whoa. Oh, there it is. Take her down. Take her down. Woo. That was a good place kick.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
Wow.
I feel like I needed to win like that.
Huge punch for the victory.
I needed to win that way because the ground technique was not working on this girl.
Let's take a look at the replay. Here is the big right hand that ends this fight. Boom, right on the money. Let's see it one more time. Look at the power.
Oh, man. See, like, Ripley goes into like a flurry of strikes. She's got that combo.
From a different angle.
What happened to her arm?
Bam, lights out.
And then I like tripped over at the end there.
Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 45 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by
Razor victorious with the knockout.
Successful KO. Honestly, I felt like I said I had to deal with her that way, because she had a really, really solid ground game, and her defense against the submission was phenomenal. No matter what I did, she got out of it. And I gotta get used to it. I'm used to seeing the blue as my arrow, but it was red because I was in the red corner. All right, looking good though. 1,000 Evo points. I call them experience points. All right, so that fight is in the books. I was a little bit concerned there, but look at that. We are number 6 on the list. The only one above us is Rhonda. I was trying to think of her middle nickname, but it's Rowdy Ronda Rousey. Rowdy Ronda Rousey. Rowdy Rousey. Based off of Rowdy Roddy Piper. Anyway, I wonder if I'm going to be fighting her anytime soon. That would be pretty cool. Nope, not yet. We're facing Jessica Anrad. She's a Muay Thai. Holy cock nuggets though, bro. Is she a champ? Why has she got the gold on her? But she's a good stand-up. A good clinch and a decent ground, but not a... Oh, Jesus. Why are you giving me this now?
It's all relevant.
See? Anyway, I think that's what happens when you have the adaptive AI. They just make their skill a lot higher than yours, so you gotta be super careful. Which can be kind of frustrating. I thought they just increased the difficulty of the AI as it goes, not just, like, pad their stats. Anyway, everything does stamina of 100, these first one. That really, really sucks. This one does up the chin, though, so I feel like I'll have to work the ground. How about the takedown defense? You know what? I kind of want to up my takedown as much as we can go. And of course, we're down by clinch power. Thanks for that. At least we don't have a short training sesh. So my clinch power is very much, well, it's down by 5. So I'll up this. I'll definitely up this. Get that really up there. Wait a minute. We lost stamina. Oh, that was the wear and tear. We're about to get it right the hell back. 99 anyway, so that's okay. Four stamina I lost on that, guys, and my leg health went down. So I think I want to take the chin here. I think I want to do a chin upgrade for the ground training. So doing that is kind of a bitch. So what I think I might do, I think if I do a hard rank, 92 overall. I think we really want to get that higher. Yeah, this will get us that stamina. How about medium? No, it won't work. So we'll get this up, we'll get our stamina back, and we'll get our chin to 70, which is the highest I think it's ever been. Actually, it may have been a 70 in my main career, in my male career, male character, but I'm not sure. So we lost our stamina and leg health. So really the only thing we lost today was leg health and clinch power. We got everything, we got the stamina right back up where we had it. Plus we got our skills up. Off the back, it can still be upgraded to, I'm assuming, at 100. So that's pretty impressive. So overall, we're probably sitting at about an 85, maybe an 86, probably an 85 though. 85 overall, that's my guess. Where are we? We're in the same spot we were the other day. We're in LA, Staples Center. Yeah, we're an 85 overall. Which is kind of... No, it makes sense. It makes sense. Alright, I have a feeling this is going to be a difficult fight. I really do. So I'm going to... I don't know. I might work on this submission game, but the stats, I think, are just a little too different.
Coming up next, it's a women's bantamweight matchup between Jessica Andrade and Razor.
So it's Andrade...
Razor, coming off a great training camp.
I wonder what they're saying. Whoop, there it is. Let me hear you say. All the bitches say. All the motherfuckers say. Whoop, there it is.
One of her best assets. She keeps a very fast pace, and you can literally see opponents start to wilt in the second and third round when they're being forced to try to keep up with her.
But it's already getting difficult.
Razor set to do battle here tonight inside the octagon.
Oh, tail of the tape.
Jessica,
oh, she's yellow because she's from Brazil.
Great training camp. She is very confident as she makes her way to the octagon.
This girl has outstanding defense and very good blocking technique. It's so difficult to hit her cleanly. It is a big advantage for her, and she has so much confidence in her defense because of that.
Jessica Andrade enters the octagon.
Andrade, that's an interesting way to spell Andrade. There's no G. But again, she's Brazilian, so.
Tail of the tape for this women's bantamweight battle. Razor is 23. Andrade is 27. Razor is 6 inches taller. She will have a 6-inch reach advantage.
All right.
Bruce Buffer.
So I have the height and I have the age.
And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer, holding the national record of 20 wins, 10 losses. She stands 5 feet 2 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds, fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Jessica Batista Andrade. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
Eve Levine, our referee for this fight in the women's division. Here we go.
All right.
Scheduled for 3 5-minute
Let's
rounds.
Do this.
White trunks for Razor. Black trunks for Andrade.
Whoa, I'm already down on the ground. Up quick,
and
though.
Up. Andrade gets hit with that kick to the midsection. Nice work on the counter.
Oh, my down. God. This is getting annoying.
She's really mixing things up nicely.
Oh, my God.
Andrade.
Stop, back, stop. Holy shit.
Nice, oh, nice. Kick.
Joe, good kick to the body by Razor.
There you go, that's all about that timing.
Joe, she lands another head kick. Her opponent needs to defend.
Oh, I walked.
Timing this combination of strikes here.
I walked into that one.
Nice front kick.
They have started this fight off with a brawl.
Right, but when she runs away, I gotta wait for her to make her move.
Oh, nice.
Oh, good combination.
Come on.
And there's another nice kick. Very nice kicks here.
Big straight to the body by Andrade.
And they go for her?
Inside leg kick.
Nope, not in time. Didn't do it in time.
And
you really,
scores a single
you really gotta
down.
Be on top of your game.
She gets
see
if
we can guillotine her. Nope, she blocks it.
Great work from the bottom.
Her left eye looks really
I got her
nasty.
Off of me.
It's starting to swell bad. Nice shot.
Great use of the kicks.
Holy shit, man. This girl's quick.
One to the body.
Andrade with a good straight leg. And she times her strikes again. Switches the stance. Great spinning.
Working that mid.
Right to the body.
Here's another very nice kick.
She just keeps backing up.
That huge head kick was blocked.
What the hell? It wasn't working. I was hitting her.
To the body.
Okay, that is some annoying bullshit when you do that.
Gets back up again. Andrade with a good connection.
Just missed.
I got good stamina.
Joe, that's a nice counter, Joe. Takedown. Final minute of the round.
Can I get the full guard? This girl is good on the ground.
Joe, she's showcasing some great movement on the ground.
It's not a good place to be, though. Oh, shit.
She's got the neck. One arm
I don't know how I'm going to get out of this. Honestly, look.
She's got that guillotine locked up.
I'm almost there.
This is nasty. This is really tight.
I can't get out of here.
This may be the end, Joe. Round one took.
Oh my God.
To a close.
Woo! That was close.
Still alive.
I thought I was down for good.
Submission attempt late in that round.
That is that's crazy, man.
Submission attempt at the end of that round. And here we see some beautiful submission offense here. Let's see this again.
Yeah, she dominated me on the ground, man. She's got that skill.
And let's see if we could get a better look at that.
And people are saying I play this on the difficulty too easy. That's tricky. I couldn't deal with that well. And I would have lost. That's crazy.
You ready?
Second round.
All right. Backing up.
Joe, that was well done blocking the punch.
She's got a good chin, man.
Good body shot. Nicely done. Even I saw that one coming.
Come on. She keeps backing away.
Ah, nice straight punch.
Great
exchange.
She has done so much damage with her.
Oh, God, I can't. That always happens to them. Have you noticed? Like, whenever they go for a kick and I kick them, they're always on their feet or they go through me.
Hook by Razor.
Adaptive AI, though.
We go inside the numbers.
Tried a Superman punch.
The total strikes line. Andrade with the jab.
I got a block.
Her strike.
Whoa!
Standing to that. Excellent head movement. Beautiful right leg kick there.
Andrade with some solid kicks.
Damn!
That kick to the body blocked by Andrade. Nice combination. She's mixing things up.
Oh, I thought I got that. Oh, my God. I just got to get up. That's all I got to do. She blocks every move I make.
3 minutes remain in the round.
Like, look. Okay, I'm up.
They clinch.
Let's try and break it.
Andrade's got the double under.
Can't do it. There we go. All right, we're back.
And move out of the clinch. Nice kick by Razor. Midway point of the fight. Andrade with a strong hook to the body.
Nice knee to the body. Excellent job of timing these combinations.
Come on, man.
Razor with a nice hook. Good strikes. And again the hook lands.
Oh, God. And then runs away so she heals up.
Andrade with a big leg kick.
Oh, my blocking. It just does not work it.
She gets a single leg takedown.
Very difficult, this. But she blocks everything. All right, here we go. Got her in the rear naked. Oh, no. What?
Great transition to top position.
I had to get. Oh, see, every move.
Found a home for that. Back to full guard. Wow. Back up. Precise jab.
Whoa. Oh, come on!
Solid shot to the big shots.
I'm so tired, though.
Oh, beautiful hook.
Nice combination.
Big punch. Vicious combination.
Whoa!
Head kick. Hard straight punch.
I don't know. I think I took it at that last little bit too. Damn, dude. That's round two. She does not go down. She knows how to keep herself standing. See, what I needed to do was take her down when she was stumbling.
A big leg kick.
And then maybe just ground and pound. That's probably a good idea. They keep showing hers. There we go, finally. Good Lord.
What a great round this fight.
All right, the final round, man. I got to keep her standing because, like I said, the ground is murder for me right now with her. She's too good on the ground.
Kick to the body.
That axe kick is just delicate.
Andrade gets nailed by that head kick.
Beautiful combination.
Joe, that's a big right hook.
Good job of timing strikes here.
Oh! Oh!
Trying to stay out of trouble here.
Huge kicks. Head kick. Nice knee.
Gotta get that stamina. Double leg takedown.
And she completes a double leg takedown.
Got her in the heel hook.
She's trying to secure this ankle lock.
She's too good, man. I don't know.
Nice. Pops that leg out of there.
Trying again.
Looking to attack that leg.
Yeah, she's too quick. I gotta let her up.
Good scramble. Beautiful.
Oh, see, every time. They know what they're doing.
Lands a clean flying knee.
Not real. Oh, God. Block, 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 block. Wake up.
Oh. They are exchanging here, Mike.
Andrade with a good jab. Man, both of her eyes have started to swell very badly. You've got to wonder about her vision. And another one lands.
Oh my God, I don't want to do that spinning. Get up! I don't want that axe kick.
Back up. Head kick. Under two remains. The battle has been action-packed since the opening bell. And another.
I gotta get on that.
Quick kick.
Let's work the points. I don't think I'm gonna take her out anymore.
Razor with some big kicks. Joe, that's another solid kick. The huge head kick is blocked. Great job with the roundhouse.
I need stamina.
60 seconds remains in this fight.
Oh, big shot there.
Oh! Whoa!
That shot, she's out.
Holy shit!
Tremendous hook, landed flush for the victory.
Weren't expecting that win.
Joe, here's the finish on our fight replay. Listen,
that axe kick.
This is the shot that drops her. Perfect technique. She's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it from another angle here. This is
that was so weird.
The knockdown and the subsequent follow-up strikes for the knockout. Great angle here.
Damn, son. I thought that was going to go the distance. She was in that red zone for most of the fight. I just couldn't finish that
until
I got that critical kick.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Leving has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 11 seconds of round number 3. Going the winner by knockout, Razor.
Razor, winner by knockout.
Fantastic. I wonder if we're going to get to fight Ronda Rousey pretty soon here, man. I mean, I'm a higher rank than her now. I have to be. After winning. Actually, not necessarily. I don't know, man. We'll have to see. I could be. Andrade, she was really good, man. I thought that was going to go the full distance. Like, look where my retirement is, man. It's like, I'm not even at the second take a hit tick, so to speak. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so that fight had me a little bit worried. No, Ronda moved up as well. Look, she's in third now. Kat Zingano dropped. I don't know, I'd like to fight a lot of these girls, man. They're like badasses. But anyway, I got some experience points to spend. I'm debating on, I might actually spend them on maybe some attributes, or sorry, rather some perks. But I'll definitely take a look into them and see what's best. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. Let's try and get it to 500. Favorite as well, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't yet, be sure to follow me on my social media. Great way to do that. A great way to get in touch with me, you know, especially on Twitter and Facebook. You know, Twitter at DanQ8000, Facebook.com, DanQ8000, Instagram, DanQ8K, Snapchat, DanQ8000, all sorts of great goodies and stuff, all in the description. I really recommend you guys follow me there. Awesome way to connect with me. Also, if you want to get yourself a shirt or hoodie, there's a link in the description for my Spreadshirt shop as well. So check that out if you'd like. But other than that, that's it for me today. Thank you so much, guys. Take it easy. Have a great day. We'll see you in the next one. But until then, let's hand things over to Knox Hill. See you guys later.
Who the man with the plan? If you feel trouble, wild and wild, don't need violent and hit you 8,000. Wait a minute, hold that style and style. Damn, goddamn Billy Jack, we still riding tires flat. I hear them sirens, see shots flying, so we driving fire back. If they ain't vibing, lie with that. Got me dressed up in all black, what up? Hood up and I see them haters try to run with us, they gon' need inhalers. Gotta breathe them hard just like Darth Vader. Players, grab your respirators, night invaders get lightsabered. Mass that's on for the shooters. Move like trash to bed, intruder. Got that Glock and got them woofers. Just press play, I'll keep it moving. Who is Knox? Still, you damn fools. Keep it fresh like canned food. There ain't nothing we can't do, so tune into that DanQ. Yeah. It was never, ever a game.